Alright, let's go to the bridge district. Somewhere. Yeah. Bridge. Bridge over.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Bridge over. Faerûn waters? I don't know. Wonkapa. I think it's the Five Flagons. It's the Sky Thunderburp. I accidentally saw it while looking for quest info, how to begin the quest and stuff.
You must gather your party before venturing forth. Stand back for justice!
Maybe Jan has to talk to him.
Yes, yes. A standard tactic, that.
Here, Delise over here.
Hello, my good smiling friends.
No? Well, if anything, we'll rest just to get Jan's spells locked in. Did I have it wrong? I kind of wonder. Let's see if I can just quickly find what it might be. Alright, so yeah, 15 to 17 days after he joins the party. So kinda want to find hold on 1 second. Okay, I feel silly right now. That's for another companion, not Jan. And
don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Oh, we're in here.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run! Make way, villainy! Hero coming through! Before venturing forth.
Very noisy. Noisy peoples. Alright.
Butt kicking, for goodness!
Yes, so I've heard. So it's a lot of days, isn't it? More than you can afford, my friend. We get our thrills by backstabbing villainy at every possible chance we can get. So this is 24, this is a day just to get here.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Right, so 2 days.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
3.
Live by the sword. Live a good long.
4.
Stand back for justice.
5.
See, battle bow? Run, bow, run!
6. So 6 days.
Make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
I'm sure they're tired.
It's long past time for turnip tea. A little rest will shake the stew from our eyes and ache from our legs.
I don't like turnips.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Sleeping in the stables. Well, we didn't do it, did we? I have a bad habit of clicking done instead of rent. Alright.
Butt kicking, for goodness!
Time to get more days to pass here. You there! No, I'm leaving! 7 days.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
8. What is he wearing? Like... oh. So we don't even know what this is made out of, really. Okay.
Ugh, my legs are just aching.
Jump on my sword while you can, Eva. I won't be as gentle.
Can we rest now, please?
No, you have to walk for 2 more days. 9, I think, right? Then we just do 7, 8.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
10.
Stand back for justice.
Who's that?
I never saw much of the cities from the circus. Are they all so crowded like this?
Pretty much. I mean, you should be used to this city by now. We'll rest again.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run! Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Okay. This will be 11.
Butt kicking, for goodness!
12.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
13.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
14. 2 more times.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle!
I'm surprised we haven't been having any... like, what do you call it? Ambushes. You've been waylaid and must defend yourself. I think they were to 14. So 15?
Live by the sword. Live a good long.
16.
Stand back for justice.
Stand back for the glory of Arm.
I just came here to find some turnips. I swear.
Here we go. Bilu Jansen. Jansen. Hey, turnip boy. Who dar? Bilu? Who else, dear cousin? I see that you've gathered some formidable friends since I've last seen you. Well, they're not gnomes, but they're not a total loss either. Some of them can get through an entire battle without my needing to babysit them. Quite remarkable for the non-gnomish. Where's your elephant? Back in the circus. Judge didn't think elephants had the right to choose in a custody battle. Poor Jeffrey. Nailed me with a theft charge, too. Just got out of prison. Legally? No, they should hire a better locksmith. Listen, Yad, you haven't come by the house for a long time. We've been looking for you. Yeah, we've been running back and forth from here to the Druid Grove looking for you. So that's where he's been. Have you? Is something wrong? It's Lissa. She's staying with us now. Did he hurt her? You should talk to her yourself. I promised to give you the message, but I have to go. Been dodging bounty hunters for days. Farewell, cousin. See you soon. Farewell, Bilu.
It looks like something serious is afoot. I'll have to be heading back to my home in the slums district.
Aw, tired of your pointless tales. Is it something that I could help with? You're welcome to come with me. I know not what the story will be, so I'm not sure if you'll actually need to do something. Perhaps you should tell us who Lissa is and why you're worried about her. It's not an easy tale for me to tell. This girl, Lissa, that my cousin mentioned, is an old friend of mine. More than a friend, I should say. She grew up poor, like me. It was a hard life, but there was happiness to be found. I love Lissa like I've never loved another. She was the most beautiful girl in Athkatla. I was not the only one to think so, however. She had several suitors when she came of marrying age. I worried little about it. I was her closest friend, and she claimed to love me. There are many gnomish families in Athkatla. Life is very different for gnomes, so used to the woods and caves of the country. Many of the families struggle with poverty in exchange for the safety of the city walls and Omnian law. Some families do very well. He came from one such family. Valag is the gnome who runs all business in the gnomish areas of Athkatla. What business? I refer to unsavory business. Loan sharking, smuggling, and so forth. Valag is a thief who pretends to be an honest merchant. Rumor has it that he reports directly to the Shadow Thieves. Regardless, he was not a pleasant person. He was a bully and a cruel man. He enjoyed exercising power. He was also suave, sophisticated, and very, very rich. I had asked Lissa to marry me, and she agreed. We were to be married at the Midsummer's Festival the following year. That was before she'd met Valag. Like most men, he took a liking to her immediately. He swept her off her feet. He showered her with gifts and city cultural events. At the time, my bitterness had me believe that he cast some sort of spell on her. In retrospect, knowing what I do about magic, she chose him of her own volition. She was pregnant shortly afterwards, and they were married. Oh, that's horrible. I would have given her that world, had I been able. I don't really believe it matters anymore. I just want her to be happy. Valag is a petty and cruel man, but she loved him more than she loved me. There's nothing else to tell. If you're ready, I'd like to get to my home in Athkatla now. We shall get there as soon as possible. Jansen returns... stuff. To help his former love, Lissa. After meeting up with his cousin, Bilu, Jan was informed that he is needed back at his home in the slums district. Apparently, there is some kind of trouble with the former love of his that married herself to another man. I've agreed to go with him. Alright. Hopefully it doesn't mess things up. We gotta rest. We've been up for 4 days without resting.
See, Battlebo? Run, Bo, run! Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Asleep as a peasant once again. Okay. Okay, Jan, let's go. Is he still with us? Yeah.
You point! Butt kicking! For goodness! Where Minsk goes! Evil stands aside.
I like going to the city gates area because you can easily, it's so small, you could easily quickly get off of it and to whatever district you want. That's my strategy. All right, so back to the slums.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Back to Jan Jansen. House. What's the storekeep doing here?
Anything you need, I can likely provide, I assure you.
I don't think we had anyone selling stuff on the street out here. I guess I forgot. Well, hello, my good lord. You look like a connoisseur of fine wares with a keen eye as well. I might have a few trinkets to interest one such as you. These trinkets of yours wouldn't be stolen, would they? Ah, stolen is such a relative concept, my lord. It is better to say that these trinkets have found their way through various means into a market that redistributes them. Some articles may be missed, aye, but others may not. Alas, I can only turn a blind eye and simply offer them at a fair and low price to my customers. Well, very well, let's see what you have. I see my eye for a potential customer has not failed me. Here, let me show you some of the goods I have acquired just for you. Just for me. That sounds ominous. Bullets, no magical ones. And we just sold a bunch of stuff recently. Yeah, we don't need any of this stuff. So, yeah, your eye for potential customer has indeed failed you. Oh, it's a rat. I was like, where's Kylie? Got a rat there instead. This building smells strongly of turnips.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
I'm home.
You must gather your party before turnips. Tot says, Mommy, Jan's back. And Tat says, Jan, did you bring me some candy? Calmly, little ones. I've brought you each a flasher. I want to use it right now, says Tot. Where's the cat? You'd use it on a cat? It's my cat, stupid, says Tat. I get to flash him. Those are the twins, of course. The girl is Tat, the boy is Tot. They are my youngest cousins, Glandig's children. Where is this Glandig? He's most likely working in the mines. My mother watches his children when he's away. They're actually quite impoverished since his wife died. These tales are best kept for another time. Follow me. I must speak with my mother. Really? You're cutting off a story? Strange times indeed, Ma says, It's good to see you, Jan. You don't stop to see your old mother anymore. I have to send your no-good cousins out to find you. I'm sorry, Ma. The turnip trade is a demanding mistress. Not so demanding as your own mother, boy. You've been in trouble, I suppose. Of course not, Ma. I've been very good. Why, look at the fine bunch of people I'm traveling with. Humph. If you say so. Thanks. What's going on, Ma? Bilou made it sound quite urgent. Lissa has been staying with us for a while. Her daughter, too. We just thought that you might want to know. She does seem to need your help, with her parents passed on and all. But he's been here. He was downstairs in the garden when we got him. Oh, I guess, technically, we have been running back and forth for like 2 months. So I guess, not 2 months, 2 weeks, almost. Yeah, it was 16 days. Yeah, over 2 weeks. With all the sleeping, too, yeah, about 2.5 weeks. So, it could have been that long. Close to it. Is she all right? Did he hurt her? Lissa's not hurt. It's the little girl. I gave them your old room. The girl is sick, and Lissa is with her. Why don't you go and talk to her? She's been waiting for you. Okay, Ma. I'll head upstairs immediately. Sapphire, please come with me. It says what? The problem at John's home appears to be that his former love, Lissa, has arrived to stay, bringing with her sick daughter. She needs John's help, according to his mother, and he needs to go to his old room to speak to her. Oh, well, we're in the room.
You haven't seen Griffins about, have you?
Oh, Jan, I've missed you. I wish I'd known you were coming today. I would have prepared a meal for you and your companions. I'm an awful mess. You look fine, Liss. You look beautiful. I've missed you, Jan. You disappeared for a long time after the wedding, and you, when you returned, I hardly saw you at all. You should have come to visit me, Jan. I couldn't, Liss. I mean, I didn't want to intrude on you and Valak. It wasn't my place to. I'm sorry, Jan. I've been terrible to you. Everything has come crashing down on me. Please forgive me, Jan. You don't have to apologize, Liss. I would do anything to make you happy. Tell me what happened. What's wrong with your daughter? She's hurt, Jan. I don't know what's wrong with her. She's just lies in bed staring at the wall, won't even eat. Please heal her, Jan. She's just a little girl. Well, Jan is a thief illusionist and does not have healing powers. When did this start? It started a few months ago, before it ended with Valak. He was always a cruel father and hard on Jayla? I don't know. He beat her if she did anything he didn't like. Min says, someone has rattled the little one's brains? I know how she feels. If this was done on purpose, he deserves a mighty kick in the posterior at the least. Aerie says, this was done by her father? Oh, how horrible. We've got to help her. Jan says, did this happen after that bastard beat her? I don't know, Jan. Can you help her? She isn't physically harmed, Liss. It is her mind that has been injured. My magic can do nothing for this sort of thing. Have you spoken with Uncle Gerhardt? Yes, but he told me that you could help. Excuse me, Liss. Sapphire, could you go to the basement and speak with my Uncle Gerhardt? Maybe find out what he knows about this illness. He's a bit eccentric, but he knows more than he lets on. I guess that we have 10 days before Jayla will die. Okay, so Jan's saying that he's eccentric. He must be mega eccentric. He's in the basement, you say? Yes, I'll go and discover what he knows. Thank you. I'll stay here with Lissa. I have to. It's hard to explain. I think I understand. I'll be back when I've found your uncle. Lissa's daughter, something. Seems to have come down with a mysterious illness of the mind. Jan's uncle Gerhardt told Lissa that Jan could heal the girl, but Jan doesn't seem to agree. He has asked me to go to the basement and ask his uncle what he knows about the little girl's illness. So there's Lissa. There's the little girl, Jayla.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Oh, you're fine enough, I suppose.
Please help my daughter. Okay, so Jan's... he's technically left the group at this point.
Please, you must go and find out exactly what my Uncle Gerhardt knows about Jayla's condition.
Oh. You'll find him in the basement. Okay, so we know it's Jayla. Jayla. Maybe it is Jan. Because this is Jayla. Alright, let's go look for the father then. I mean the uncle.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
I'm glad to hear that you're helping poor Jan. Tit for tat. Leave my kitty alone. What will you do if I touch your cat? I'll bite your kneecaps. And you? Tat keeps pinching me. And you? Cat has nothing to say. How rude. Alright, let's go downstairs. Uncle Gerhardt. Well, if he could leave the room at some point, we could loot this stuff.
Stand back for justice!
Maybe he'll say Jan's name. No, you don't talk. Who in the blazes are you? Small noses, rancid smell? Be you gibberlings? We are the Gibberlings 3. Is Mary a bandage evidence? I mean, we could say this, but I don't know if that's going to further the quest. Pardon me? Aye, stupid too. Jiblings for sure. Well, I've nary a sausage to feed you. Have you come to devour Athkatla? Okay, now I want to see the Jiblings theory thing, but it's not there. We'll devour you if you don't tell us what we need to know. Indeed, it's been quite tasty so far. Listen, we're not here to devour everything. Or anything. In fact, we'd like to help a little girl named Jaella. Aye, she's been hurt. Poor lass. Where's that cursed potion? What particular potion do you need? Not a potion, Boris. Fool, a sausage. Are you hungry? Methinks I've got some sausages under me bed. I'm fine, really. Wait, does he have sausages? Thank you, I'm feeling a bit peckish. Well, I've nary a sausage to feed. Okay, never mind. Let's stop this charade. Jan sent us down here to ask you a few questions. That boy's full of questions. True, true, true. Are you hungry? Methinks I've got some sausages under me bed. I'm fine, really. Because you don't have any. Do you have any idea what might be causing that little girl's illness? You've come about the girl, eh? Yes. Do you know anything about her illness? 'Tis a hurt of the mind. Only one rich in such powers can heal her. Where can I find such a person? The Hidden is the one you see. The one you seek. Go to Gistev at her estate in the government district. She'll lead you to the Hidden. Now where's that sausage? Gistev estate. To the Hidden? Jan's uncle seems to think that we need the aid of something called the Hidden to heal Lissa's daughter. He directed me to the Lady Gistev, who lives in an estate in the government district, saying that she could lead me to it. I should go and tell Jan of this news immediately. Okay, anything else to say?
I just came here to find some turnips, I swear!
I've wasted me life. Where's that sausage? Are you still here? Get moving, child. Now. Now. Bossy. And crazy.
See, battle bow, run, bow, run.
Nothing new to say here. Nope.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Hi.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through.
I should have better explained the situation.
Gerhardt is a well-known and respected physician and scholar. He had risen above the poverty that plagues this family, so, as you have seen, he is no longer the same. About a decade ago, my uncle was hired to treat a rather unsavory fellow, a thief named Ralg. It was fairly obvious that Ralg was a high-ranking shadow thief. He had power and money, two things more than rare in Athkatla without family connections. Ralg was also daring. There are places in this city where no sane man treads, places in the bowels of the earth that have the most powerful drow clerics quavering with fear at the mere mention of their cursed names. Ralg set into motion the systematic plunder of these places. He was a modern man, not given to the superstitious fears of the plebeian masses. The story goes that Ralg was found in the old temple of Baal, gibbering and mad with fear. Uncle Gerhardt, an expert in odd conditions, was called to treat the ravaged man. As my uncle had learned through his studies, these afflictions can never be treated without knowledge of their cause. Since none but Ralg had survived the trip, my uncle made the foolish decision to travel to these unholy places in search of this knowledge. He left for the graveyard and the places of the profane that are known to lie beneath it. He was gone for months, and we thought him dead. Ralg was shipped off to the asylum that lies off of Am's coast. Nearly a year later, Uncle Gerhardt returned a changed man. Something that he had seen on his travels left him quite unhinged, though hardly the mindless sack of flesh that Ralg had been. With this change came a strange ability that occasionally shows itself in Gerhard's verbal ramblings. He has become a prophet of sorts. He predicts events, some small and some of portent. During the time of troubles, his gift was particularly evident. He seemed to know everything. He'd rage and stumble about the basement, screaming of slaughtered gods and tumultuous magic. But that is in the past. He has examined Jaela, and, especially in his present state, he knows things. He told Lissa to bring me home, and I hope that he has given you some direction as to how he can help this girl. After all that, now he finally wants to know what his uncle said. Well, amongst the ramblings about sausages and chickens, he did have a few things to say. He said that for one, to heal Jaela's mind, one must know one's own mind. He also mentioned something about seeking the hidden. The hidden, you say? Lissa mentioned this. It seems that Lady Gistev knows something of the man. You can find the Gistev estate in the government district. Yep, I've been there. Looted it. Will you solve this mystery for me? I must stay with Lissa. Yes, I will try to find the hidden and a cure for Jaela. Thank you, friend. Go well. I shall be here when you return. Jaela's not eating, so I estimate you have 10 days at most. Huh. 10 days. Jan will stay behind to nurse Jaela and has bid me to talk to Lady Gistev and find the hidden. He estimates I have 10 days at most before the young girl dies. I must head off to the government district and the Gistev estate as soon as possible. Please help my daughter. He doesn't respond. Okay. So we're a quintet for now.
Butt kicking, for goodness!
Oh, because he's not in the group. She says that thing again. Alright. Just to have a state.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Back to the government district.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Okay, then evil will stand aside of the government district. Funny enough, it's where we found him. Where we found Jan. Or Jan. Remember. Sounds like he says oil, but I think he's saying why you. I'm not sure. Alright. Government. Boop.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Oh, I'd be bothering the Gistevs at 1 a.m. It's all good. It's fine. Over here. Fun on steps. It's like a townhouse mansion, but both connected. Attached, whatever. I mean, you can't travel from one to the other inside, not that I know of. Where are they all going?
What? Fine.
Trust is sort of foolish.
Yes. Faster than Chick. Take a fast pause.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Lady Gistev.
Stand back for justice.
Stand back for justice. Here's justice.
Stand where you're at, peasant.
Who might you be, and why you're in my estate? I only wish to ask you a question, Lady Gustav. What is it? Make it quick. I have a tea to arrange. I need to find someone called the Hidden. The Hidden? But you are not one of the Enlightened Ones. Who are the Enlightened Ones? I should not have said anything. Please, you must go before I get myself into any more trouble. Look, m'lady, I already know of him. What harm could it be to tell me where to find him? There was a girl who was ill? I should not say anything. A girl named Jaella. You can help her be healed by telling me where the Hidden can be found. Right? Unhide the Hidden. I do not know where he is. Perhaps I can arrange a meeting. Oh, he shall be so angry. Listen then. Below the cursed hole of avarice called the Copper Coronet, there lies a maze of sewer shafts. Find the place if you can. The entrance lies within the tavern somewhere. Okay. I believe we've been to where you were speaking. What you're speaking of? I shall ask the Hidden to meet you there, but I do not know where he will be or if he will show up at all. That's all I can do. Go now, before you are seen here. Huh. We were doing all these questing without him. I was able to convince Lady Gustav to arrange a meeting between myself and the Hidden. She tells me that I need to go to the sewer maze beneath the Copper Coronet, and that the Hidden should meet me somewhere there. She could not give me an exact location, nor was she sure if the Hidden would come, but she did seem very sure that he would be angry, as I am not one of the Enlightened Ones, whatever they are. The Enlightened... That's back with the Cult of the Eyeless. Does she mean that, are those the Enlightened Ones, the Cult of the Eyeless? I wonder about that. Do what you must, and then remove yourself. I've people of culture to impress, and you foul the air somewhat. How charming.
See, Battle Bo? Run, Bo, run!
I guess they'd be a little more nicer if your reputation was better. I'm sure they'd still be... talking nobles and personages in power and prestige. That she'd be, you know, maybe a little nicer, but still hoity-toity, I'm sure. Hoity-toity. So we're going back to the Copper Coronet. Damn. Really? We got a lot of experience just for talking to her. That's crazy. 8,900? I didn't notice that at first.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Alright, so it's right over here. You might as well just go talk to him really quick. Maybe fill him in. Maybe he'll have some insight on where to find this Hidden. He seemed to know something about the Hidden, so maybe he'll be able to help out in some way.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
More likely, think he will just
make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
He will just make way, villainy. More likely, I think he'll just say the same thing. You can keep your 2 gold.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
But kicking for goodness! Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
He doesn't talk.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Help daughter, okay. Oops.
You must gather your party before venturing forth. You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Yes, gathering party, venturing forth. All that fun
stand
stuff.
Stand back for justice.
Move that crate out of my way. You're a heifer and a hoe. No, I didn't say that. Alright, so...
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
We can find the tunnels of doom over here. I think it's at the end of this hallway. Where are they going? You show off. What the hell? It's down here. Come on, slowpokes. Taking the scenic route over there. We must gather our party before venturing forth. Don't you understand?